What do you expect? How can we do anything but bust up petting parties if you won't give us no stool pigeons to work with? Them, they're only flat-footed cops. A dame could spot them a mile off. Okay.
But my dear girl, I am engaged. Worse, you're an ambassador's wife. On top of that, he's my chief. Why, you must see, the whole thing is ridiculous.
Then this is the end? You mean you aren't ever going to see me again?
No, why, of course, it's part of my job. But not this way. I never should have come in the first place.
What's that?
Turn on the light.
Hey, wait a minute.
What's the matter?
Vice Squad.
What do you want?
You can't park in here with your lights out.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't know.
Well, I'll take your names anyway.
Why? What for?
Neckin'.
Oh, we were just sitting here talking.
Yeah, that's what they all say. What's your name, miss?
Don't tell you.
I'll have you reported for this.
Oh, gonna get tough, huh?
Now, be reasonable, please. What good little names do you? We could give you any name.
Yeah? Well, I'll just take your number.
Stay in, Stephen. Stay in.
Wait a minute, officer, please. This lady is married.
How did it happen?
She ran right over him and just drove away.
Were you in the car too?
No, no, not when it happened. I'd got out.
Well, you were with her. Who is she?
I can't. I won't tell you that.
No? D2. That's part of a license number.
So that's it. He's taken down the number and she rides right over him, eh? That ain't accident, mister. That's murder. I gotta hold you for this.
But I didn't do anything.
Well, you know who did it. That makes you an accessory anyway.
But be sensible, officer. I'm a member of a foreign embassy. You can't arrest me.
You're what?
If you want to prove it, call up the Park Hotel. The ambassador is giving a ball tonight. I've got to go down there. I'm late as it is.
Yeah? Well, you're coming along with me. Get in. Make it snappy.
What's up?
One of my men got run over. Look after the body till the coroner gets here. I'll report it.
Okay.
I have a good mind to call the whole thing off.
Why pick on me? I'm only your brother. Maybe he couldn't find his collar button.
I don't see anything funny about it. Everybody's noticed that he isn't here. It just looks as though he were trying to avoid announcing his own engagement. Makes a fool out of me.
Oh, Alice, have a heart. Even the ambassador isn't here yet. Where's Stephen? Hasn't run out on you already, has he, Alice?
He can't run that fast.
What are you? A marathon runner?
That sort of thing.
Oh, he was just trying to be funny.
I wouldn't care so much if everyone weren't here. At least everyone that matters.
His Excellency, the Ambassador.
night. It was my fault, wasn't it? These New York dressmakers.
Dressmakers anywhere.
You can get your dinner on the clock.
I'll give you 5 minutes, no more.
Thanks, officer. I won't forget this.
What's the matter, Helen? Headache?
Yes, rather.
Oh, I'm sorry. Hello, Judge. You'll have to forgive me.
Have to?
If you don't mind, I'll leave you two to fight it out.
Something's come up. I can't stay but a minute.
Stephen!
No, please, Ali. It's terribly important.
But how is that going to look? You can't go. What am I going to do about the announcement?
That's why I came. You'll have to put it off. Please, Ali, dear. Try to understand. Trust me.
You ask a great deal, Stephen. How do you think I'm going to explain this to everybody?
Tell them you broke it off. You're sick of me, anything.
Broke it off? Why? Aren't you ever coming back?
Well, of course. But it may be some time. A long time. It isn't fair to you.
Don't be foolish. You sound as though you were never coming back. Perhaps you prefer it that way. You seem to know what you're doing.
No, please, Ali, dear, don't take it that way. I really have to go. Go right now.
Why, Major, when did you get here? Aren't you staying?
I'm sorry, I have to go along.
But what's the matter, Stephen, my boy? Anything I can do?
No, sir, thank you.
No trouble, Al.
No, sir.
Why don't you know the Major's the one man who would never bring discredit on the embassy?
Thank you.
Dames, don't you?
What's that to you?
I was just thinking. Of course, I could tell them it was a hit-and-run driver and he got away.
What do you mean? Why should you?
I could use a guy like you in my business instead of the tramps they hand me.
Me? Paul.
Well, it'd be all right with you, wouldn't it? Better than having to go to jail, backing up against a jury, doing time for murder.
Naturally, anything would be better, but...
Anything?
Yes, why?
No dame would be able to spot you a mile off.
.460, that's the number. Pull up there. Here's the mark, Bill. I'll give you about 3 minutes, then toss the cigarette out. Very well.
Does Miss Somerset live here?
Oh, hello. Who are you?
A friend of yours sent me. I think you call him Eddie.
Oh, sure. Come on in.
Come on.
Doing in your room?
Oh, well, I thought that maybe he was one of the gentlemen with a room on the same floor. He acted so polite and everything, like a real gentleman. I figured that maybe he was down on his luck and feeling lonely and just wanted to converse. But if I'd have known what he was after...
90 days.
Oh, Judge.
Next case.
And when we busted into her room, there was a guy there.
Who, officer? What's his name?
I don't know, sir.
Why don't you? Why is it, officer, that in these cases... nobody ever seems to know who the men were who were found in the women's rooms. And why aren't these men ever brought into court? Tell me that.
Well, you see, Your Honor, we get the guy's name and address, but they're always phony.
Honest, Judge, I thought he was a gentleman.
511 West 9th Street. The chief had information.
And with his cane and his talk, I figured he was a foreign gentleman. I thought he didn't have no friends to talk to.
He had an accent. So how was I to know what he was talking about?
Now, Miss Somerset, did there seem to be anything fishy about this man?
Sure. Yes, sir. I figured right off he might be a plant.
What do you mean by that? How, a plant?
A guy hired by the police to try to make me look bad. You know, a stool pigeon.
Wait a minute. Have you any proof of this, Mr. Miller? Any evidence to support that?
Why, no, Your Honor. But I wanted to bring out that they might have used one.
Might have isn't enough. If you've got proof, I want it brought out. This court wouldn't think of convicting anybody where a stool pigeon was concerned.
But neither will I tolerate unfounded suggestions intended to create false sympathy for a defendant.
Why, there he is. That's him. That's him now.
Quiet. Order in the courtroom.
Who? That's who?
The guy I was telling you about. He just went out.
Go after him.
Bring him back here.
Yes, sir.
The guy with the cane.
Quiet. Order in the courtroom.
Hey, you. Wait a minute. You were the cane.
Me?
Yes, you. Was you in the courtroom just now?
Courtroom? Where?
Night court.
No, why?
Sure?
Quite sure. I was just walking by the place, but why?
Well, he had a cane, and you're the only one I see.
I'm sorry, but I don't understand. Somebody steal a cane? I can assure you it's mine. It has my initials.
Yeah, you better come on back with me.
But why? What's the idea?
The judge wants to see you. If you're not the guy, you've got nothing to worry about.
Just as you wish. Well, would you be kind enough to tell me what I am wanted for? Murder, theft, arson, or what?
Here he comes. He's got him. I ain't sure whether it's the one, Your Honor, but he's got a cane.
That's him, all right.
Stephen, you've made a silly mistake, my girl. I know this gentleman.
Come into my chambers, Major, and I'll explain.
But Judge, it's him.
Recess.
I guess I ought to know. I suppose you've never seen me before.
I haven't had that pleasure.
You are fantastic. You vanish from your friends as if you never existed, then pop up out of nowhere like this.
But what is it?
Nothing. Just complete nonsense. I send Eddie chasing a man I think's a stool pigeon. And out of 6 million people, he picks you. Forgive my laughing, but it is funny.
Stool pigeon? Informer. Agent provocateur in your country. Oh. Me?
Are you back at the embassy?
No. Oh, no.
Then what are you doing? You're certainly looking prosperous enough.
Oh. Well, quite. But I'm not doing anything exactly. That is, not at the moment. Just looking about.
Hard to dig up anything big enough, eh? You know, I've often thought it must be tough on men like you. You can't just shift around when you're used to practically juggling empires. But we mediocre fellas can just jump from job to job.
No, 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 you flatter me.
Where are you living? Not down in the village, are you?
Oh, no, no, no.
Got a swanky place out of town, I suppose.
Well, not very swanky, I'm afraid. Thanks.
Of course, I've never got it straight why you ducked out of everything the way you did. Naturally, since it was all right with Alice, it was none of my business. I don't believe in a brother messing in his sister's affairs. But it seemed too bad for you two to call everything off the way you did.
Then she didn't tell you?
Of course she told me. Told me as much as she knew herself. But it didn't seem to make much sense even to her. Just because you'd had a row of some kind with your chief.
My diplomatic career was gone. I explained that...
She'd have been game if you'd given her half a chance.
Judge, there are still several cases waiting.
Yes, yes, of course. I'll be right out. Thank you. Now, look here. I have to go back. But I want to have a real talk with you. Hear all you've been doing the last 2 years. Come on out and sit on the bench with me.
Oh, an agent provocateur on the bench might be embarrassing.
It might at that. She'd have to stick to her story. Yes. Then wait in here. I won't be 20 minutes. We can walk over to my apartment. It's near here.
Yes, thank you. Thanks very much, but...
Nonsense. See, Alice will never forgive me if she doesn't see you.
I'd never forgive myself, but...
I'll be right back.
No. Never mind. Here he is now. Shut that door. What was you doing in night court? Ain't you got any sense? No magistrate would ever give us a conviction if he knew we was using you guys. You might get us all into trouble.
Sorry. I was just curious. I wanted to see if the magistrate was a man I used to know. But you're right. It was a mistake.
Oh, a mistake, huh? I suppose I could tell that to the inspector if he busted me for using stool pigeons. Well, next time, if you want to get your dough, don't make no mistake.
I don't want your money. Keep it.
No? Going to pull that.
I've had enough. Dirty, sneaking business.
Oh, turned your stomach, huh? Always getting finicky. I'm getting sick of that tripe from you.
You're doing all right. $30 ain't bad for one night's work. You could do worse.
Haven't I done enough of your dirty work? Tricked enough girls for you?
What do you mean? They were guilty, weren't they?
What if they were? Expect me to go on forever making you a reputation for arrest?
There's one arrest I've held off making for 2 years now.
What kind of a man are you? Do you think you can go on forever digging your heel in a man's neck? The only way out with you is to let you go ahead. Do your worst.
You won't take no chances with a jury on a murder indictment.
There is no murder indictment for me.
No? Well, it wouldn't take a grand jury long to vote one. Get some sense. All you gotta do is to keep on playing along with me for a while. You help me, I help you, see? That's fair, ain't it?
Eminently fair. Except that I have to live with myself. Every day, look in the mirror and see myself.
I'll go on and get drunk like you usually do.
Of course, there is one way I can elude you, Sergeant. Elude myself.
Sure, stay drunk. But not so drunk you don't show up tomorrow night.
Why aren't you a drinking man, Sergeant? You must have some cure for self-contempt.
Things too straight.
Hello, Mother.
Get this. Your father and I don't understand why, if you want to be a writer, you can't do it here at home instead of in New York. Anyway, there's no reason for your staying down in that Greenwich Village section. It's no place for a nice girl to be living by herself. Wait till you hear what Dad thinks about you. He can't see why you should take up with a girl like that artist model just because she happens to have a studio in the same house. Madeline, child, you must know the things a girl like that has to do. How's that?
And I thought the old man liked me, too.
Two of them. There you are, sir.
Major. Didn't know I was a major, did you, Tony?
No, Major. Come on, why don't you sit down? Anything the matter?
Oh, I'm doing all right. I could do worse. Much worse.
Look out, you go on your beam.
Can't fall. Not when you are in the bottom already.
Come on. Why don't you sit down?
A man stands before his betters.
I don't know what's got into you tonight, sir.
And I said, listen, Bronx boy, posing in the Here I Am is one thing, but...
That all?
Yeah. Run along, Tony. This is for adults. But you don't care what you do. Not as long as it pays dough, I don't.
Oh, but he's different. I've seen him in here lots of times. He always sits at that same table back near the corner and always alone. I'd like to know more about him. He acts like he's been somebody. You know, a gentleman. Yet nobody seems to know where he comes from or where he goes.
Romance, huh? Maddie, you're letting the village get you the wrong way. Have fun with these tramps down here, sure. But that gentleman tripe. That's just a lot of old Henry stories going to your head like bad gin. Well, that mug's probably nothing but a bathtub salesman.
And why did he care if that man followed me and got fresh?
Oh, I suppose that makes him a knight and a white horse, huh? Only he fights with a cane.
Well, you needn't laugh. I've never seen anything like the way he handled it, like fencing. Pretty nearly cut that masher in two.
Why don't no mashers ever go for me?
Give me time, baby, give me time. I'll do my best.
Hey, lay off. Who sent you an invitation?
Be decent, will you? Go away.
Oh, you ain't sore, are you, cutie? Come on, give us a smile.
Hey, you guys, call him off. Whistle to him.
Why, Ed, you're drunk.
How'd you get out without your muzzle on?
I don't bite.
That's about enough of that.
Oh? Pardon you.
Go back to your table. Behave yourself.
My guardian angel again.
Guardian, perhaps, but a little unsteady for an angel.
I'm not so hot for angels myself. Wing feathers tickle my nose. Come on, let's go.
Isn't he swell?
Oh, you're falling for the accent.
Help you out, sir?
There is only one way out for men like me, Tony. And we have to go alone.
I don't get you, sir.
I didn't expect you to.
He's a queer one, all right.
Take them all out of there. Mine and two girls.
Yes, sir. Hey, here's your change.
I won't need it.
How much?
Nothing. He pays for you. Here's his change. You better take it. We're not allowed to keep it.
Wouldn't he take it?
Said he didn't need it.
Well, I can use it if he can. He's drunk. Come on, give it back to him. Give it back? Are you crazy? Come on. Expect me to run after? Not in my financial condition.
You get home. Where do you live?
Ooh. Sometimes one place, sometimes another.
Well, where now?
Harrow Street.
Harrow Street? Why, that's right around the corner.
Is it?
Then you did it on purpose.
Did I?
Didn't you?
Doesn't matter.
Oh, you must be drunk. You don't know what you're doing. Come along with me. You're going home.
I'm afraid I'm not worth all this.
Maybe I think you are. What number, Harold?
89.
Hang on till you feel better. Go get a doctor. There must be one somewhere around here.
He don't need a doctor. All he needs is to give up.
He's not just drunk. He's sick, I tell you.
Oh, what if he is? What do you want to get mixed up with it for?
Please, Josie, quick.
Oh, all right. But this is a fine time of night to go waking people up. Ring in that doorbell to get them to take care of us, Tom. Can you tell me where I can find a doctor?
feeling this size.
Well, you mustn't mind. You're just feeling the reaction. Of all the bare, desolate holes.
Well, you're a lot of help.
Two suits to his name. One of them would be evening clothes.
Yeah? Another plot for a novel, I suppose.
So tragic, it's funny. Story of a gentleman. This and that.
Any food in the house?
How should we know?
Well, look, you've got eyes, haven't you?
What's the matter, Doctor? Can you tell?
Certainly. He's half starved. He's been drinking his meals too long. Come on, help me get him on the bed.
This man's sick. He's going to need care.
I found an icebox. No food. Not unless he can eat glass. Just bottles. They're empty. They would be.
There's nothing more I can do right now. He'll come out of it in a few hours. Somebody ought to stay with him.
He needs watching.
I'll stay.
Don't be a sap. This ain't your funeral.
Well, it's pretty close to being his. I'll leave you two to settle this. But whoever stays, see that he gets this. I have this filled. And get in touch with me if anything happens.
I like that, leaving us to hold the sack.
Well, you don't have to stay.
I should say not. Listen, Madeline. If you stay here, it may be a couple of days. And how's that going to look?
What do I care how it looks? Besides, I thought you said I'd never be able to write fiction unless I went places and did things.
I said if it didn't cost you nothing.
Who's going to know about it?
Plenty of people.
What if they do? What I like about it down here. People don't bother about anybody else or what they do.
Your old man would bother plenty. What if he happened to drop into town and you weren't home? Tell any respectable guy, any father, even if he is a surgeon and has seen plenty, try and tell him his daughter's spending her nights out for charity.
Dad won't even know. He always wires me when he's coming to see me.
What if he doesn't? There goes your allowance, baby. Then where'll you be?
I guess I can support myself.
What with? Rejection slip?
Besides, he hasn't a friend in the world. You can see that. Look at this room. I can't just walk out on him. I wouldn't do that to anybody, much less to somebody who's been...
Your guardian angel, huh? All right. But don't let the feathers get in your hair. And don't kid yourself, this is life with a capital L, that you'll sell it a smart set. They ain't buying that one about the good girl anymore.
Well, drop this at the drugstore and have them send it around right away, will you?
Oh, all right. You win the halo.
Just keep feeding him. He's much stronger already. As soon as he wakes up, you ought to be able to get out of bed.
I hope he doesn't have any more of those dreams. It's as if he were terribly afraid of something.
Don't worry. We all have them. He'll be all right.
Awake again?
You still here?
Better take it easy.
How long has it been?
Since night before last.
All that time? You've been here day and night?
Shocked?
No, but why? Why should you? For me?
You would have, wouldn't you? For anyone.
Perhaps, but it's different for a man.
Nobody goes on ceremony down here. Everybody's alike, just trying to get along. And you don't mind doing things for people, lending things and borrowing and, well, you know.
The first man up is the best man dressed. Obviously, you are an early riser.
I see you know how to flatter women, but it's not fair Josie brought me this. It's hers.
Then it's time you returned it. I don't want to ruin your credit.
You mean you want me to go?
Better. For your own sake, don't you think? I'd never forgive myself if you have caused any embarrassment over me. But I'm grateful, truly.
So am I, that I grabbed you in time.
But I am thanking you for more than that.
For what?
Snapping me out of it. Reminding me that everything is a little absurd. Thanks.
Of course, if you're sure you're all right.
Oh, I am. Believe me.
You haven't even asked my name. Don't you think we should introduce ourselves?
Just as one guardian angel to another?
Why not? Well, you needn't be afraid. I'm going anyhow.
Shouldn't we perhaps just remember it as an incident? Pleasant encounter? Like ships that have passed.
Why be so mysterious? You talk as if we'll never see each other again.
The signposts point that way. In opposite directions, I'm afraid.
I never read signs.
You should. It's wiser for you.
Suppose I can't read.
But at least you can see which way the finger points.
You're not very polite. So, of course, if you insist. Good luck.
Oh, does a guy named Lucano live here?
Lucano?
Yeah. Has a mustache, carries a cane.
Oh, yes, in there.
Thanks.
Hey, wait a minute. He's been sick. What do you want?
What's it to you?
No, I've been taking care of him.
And don't even know his name?
What of it?
What's your name?
That's my business.
And mine. You've seen plenty of those before. Come on, spill it.
My name's Madeline Hunt.
Where do you live?
21 Christopher Street. But I don't get what you mean.
Well, I get you, sister. And it's okay with me.
Who asked you for a massage?
Don't get tough, baby. I like you. You look like a hot number to me. Now listen. You be nice to me, and I'll be nice to you. That's fair, ain't it? It'd pay you to play ball with me, sister, in your business. So this is where you've been hiding out.
Hiding?
Yeah, faking sick.
Think so? Do I look as if I was faking?
Well, maybe not. But you don't get away with this indefinitely. Tomorrow night, you're working.
You call it work? Why, I thought you enjoyed it.
Maybe I will at that. Tomorrow night.
Really? Where do we raid? Got some nice addresses?
Plenty. 21 Christopher Street for one.
Oh. Right near the station house. No reason we shouldn't consult our convenience in these matters, is there, Sergeant?
We are on the right side of the law.
Well, you better show up tomorrow night, or you may find yourself on the wrong side.
Hello? 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 All right, come up, whoever you are.
Does Miss Hunt live here? You see, I have my ways of tracing people.
Is anything the matter? Did you want me?
No, thank you, no. But you see, I was afraid I hadn't thanked you properly. I was half sick.
Why, you did. Said more than enough. Please forget it.
I'm sorry. I've got to go.
Can't you stay a minute?
No. No, I must go.
Matter. It's a mistake.
What is?
This girl. She's not that kind. No evidence. Couldn't get any.
Is that right?
Wrong steer, I guess.
All right. Beat it.
You're through for the night. Come on, let's blow.
Now we crashed the joint.
I thought he said there wasn't no evidence.
That's what he said.
But listen, Chief.
I'm running this. Do as I tell you.
All right. But I don't like it.
Neither do I.
Open up in there. It's the police.
Wait here. You're under arrest.
Age?
24.
Married?
No.
What's the charge?
Vagrancy.
I didn't do anything. It's a frame-up, I tell you. There wasn't anyone in my room. I can prove it. A friend of mine had just left there. He'd been there only a few minutes before.
Yeah? Well, where is he?
Why, hello, Tom.
Imagine bumping into you again. Where did you disappear to the other night?
Oh, I'm sorry, I couldn't wait. I realized after you left I had something I had to do.
Well, this time you don't get away. This is where I live. Come on in.
No, I thank you very much. I really shouldn't.
No, you see, no excuses. Alice gave me blazes for letting you slip through my fingers the other night.
That was very nice of her, but some other time, please. And besides, you have court tonight.
No, I'm in traffic court this week, so you see, there's no way out. Come on in.
You have a genius, all right, for appearing out of nowhere. Then, presto, you're gone again into thin air. Just like the other day in court. Can you imagine it being Stephen when I half expected a stool pigeon?
Why not?
You, of all people.
Why? What about stool pigeons? Are they so bad?
Nothing lower on earth. If I ever knew of a case where they used them, I'd throw it out of court.
There's no excuse for men like that.
Suppose otherwise they'd starve.
Starving would be much easier, I should think.
Or prison. I've heard some have that choice. It seems strange to me that you laws permit a police officer to keep a crime secret in order to use the criminal as an informer.
They don't permit anything of the kind. Any police officer who hides a crime to make a stool pigeon is an accessory and can be sent to jail.
Are you sure?
It's the law.
Oh, well, who cares about stool pigeons when we can go out on the roof and be cool?
Perhaps you'd rather just talk.
Oh, I hate talk. You two go ahead. I have some homework to do. Copper deal I'm interested in. Sitting in court all day, never made a man enough money to live on. I'll join you later.
But if the court please, my client has a witness. She can prove what she says. Of course, we ain't been able to locate him yet, Your Honor. But if you grant me a postponement, put it over for a week, I'll be able to prove that this is a deliberate frame-up on the part of the police.
Very well, then. Case postponed. I'll set the bail at $1,000.
$1,000? But, Your Honor, my client can't afford no such bail as that. She comes from a good family, yes, but she can't call on him. She don't want her folks to know about this. It would break them all up. The disgrace.
That's an old story, Mr. Miller. Bail $1,000. The case will go over 1 week. Women's court.
You've had a bad time since then, haven't you?
Call this bad? Or this?
I mean, between then and now. Oh, why do you try to cover it up? It's no disgrace.
What's no disgrace?
To have a hard time. Be broke, for instance.
Broke? Do I look it?
I can tell. Your voice, your manner, somehow you're defensive. Not the way you used to be.
Let's talk about the past, please. It's much pleasanter.
Say, you two.
You going to stay out there all night? I'm getting so sleepy, I can't hold my head out. Come on in.
Listen, Tom, I've got a great idea. Stephen isn't doing anything right now. Why don't you let him handle that copper deal? He's been saying for months he never has time for anything but coursework.
Don't be silly, Alice.
But you said if you could only get someone you trusted.
I know, but of course I'd love to have you do it, but you wouldn't think of it. He's used to handling big jobs. He wouldn't take a picayune position like that.
How do you know? Ask him.
Would you even consider it?
Well, of course, it's very nice of you.
There, what did I tell you? Of course he wouldn't do it. I just made a fool of myself.
Oh, no. It isn't that foolish.
You'll say you'll do it. Try it. For a while, anyway.
You've no idea what it would mean to me.
Oh, I shouldn't, really.
But you will. You must.
Well, I think of it.
Great. Say, that's marvelous. Tomorrow we'll go over the whole thing. I'll introduce you to my associates and... Look here. Why don't you stay here tonight?
Oh, thanks, but I really
There's no can't. Sense of you going way out of town just to come back first thing in the morning.
Thanks, it's very nice of you, really.
I'll lend you razor, pajamas, anything you need.
No, I shouldn't.
Nonsense, come on, that's settled.
No use struggling, Stephen. You're caught.
If that guy ran into the cops on his way downstairs, he can prove that there wasn't no time for you to have nobody in your room when they busted in.
I don't want to drag his name into it.
Gonna do time just to save some guy from getting his nose dirty?
Won't they take my word for anything?
Not against the cops.
Well, anyway, I'm not gonna throw mud on somebody who's been decent to me.
But how about your family? How are you gonna keep them from finding out? You've got to beat the case. How could you ever cover up all that time? They're bound to tumble. It would break their hearts.
No, they can't. No, they mustn't ever.
Well, then tell us, who's the guy? What's his name?
Lucano, 89 Harrow Street.
That one? Well,
Lucano? Say, what's he look like?
I don't know.
Got a little mustache, carries a cane.
I remember him. A girl picked him out in court once. Why, do you know what he is? That guy's a stool pigeon.
Stool pigeon?
Listen, this will make it easy if he'll talk. Maybe he was the plant on this case. If he was, it's a pushover. I'll get you out of it like that. We'll get the case postponed, see? Stall, till it goes before a magistrate who will throw it out of court.
Who's that?
A guy named Morrison. He wouldn't convict anybody where there was a stool pigeon in the case.
nice to go like this?
I wanted to avoid a scene.
But why? Where are you going?
I can't go through with it.
Wasn't last time enough? You can't keep doing this sort of thing to me.
You don't know anything about me. I'm different, I tell you. I don't belong with decent people anymore. I oughtn't to be here. Something happened to me that I...
Can't you tell me about it?
No, please, no. I can't go into that.
You mean about your being a stool pigeon?
How did you know?
Guess.
Was it so obvious?
I know you better than Tom does. I ought to, shouldn't I?
And you knew it all the time. And yet, you wanted me to stay. No. Please, no, I can't let you do that.
Don't go. Can't you see I want you to stay?
I can't. I've made my bed. I guess I'll have to lie in it.
Oh, how do you dare talk like that? Just as if nothing mattered. That's just being weak. Don't you realize you've got a chance to live again? Live decently? Everything's ahead. Big jobs. Other jobs. Not just this. Are you going to let yourself be bullied out of it? And then laugh or shrug and pretend you put up a fight?
Why should you care so much?
I love you. You ought to know that. I always have.
What's the idea?
They've stole it, so it comes up before Morrison.
Maybe LeConner's going to squawk. You know how Morrison is about stool pigeons.
If he gets up there and spills all he knows, we'll all be in the
chair. Sure, they'll slap it on us just as much as on you.
How's he going to know she's been arrested?
If we keep him hanging around here, he's sure to get wise.
Maybe you're right. He's been squawking for a knot for a long time. I'll be big and let him have it.
Sure, there's plenty other stools.
Come in.
Hello, Sergeant. I want to have a talk with you.
What's up?
Privately.
Okay, come on, Pete.
Connor, when do you know?
I ain't seen him around.
But he'll be back, won't he?
He might. Well, I guess I'll have to wait.
Thanks, Sergeant. Don't say I never gave a guy a break. You can't do anything else. You're in just as deep as I am. If I'm a murderer, you are an accessory for keeping it secret.
Getting to be quite a lawyer, ain't you? Well, see you don't go shooting your mouth off about working with me.
Afraid I might be proud of the association? Don't worry, Sergeant. I have no reason to talk. If you don't.
What did he say?
Oh, you had the right idea. He said he'd forget it.
I knew he would. You're smiling. The first real smile of yours since 2 years ago.
I wouldn't be surprised. Just like waking up.
Happy?
Oh, that's a hopelessly inadequate word.
Well, where to?
To my country place. My swanky estate on the island, 89 Harrow Street.
Why? Why do you have to go back to that place again?
Oh, I can't abandon my most faithful retainers. They've been waiting a long time for today to come.
Who?
My evening clothes.
I'm coming in with you. I want to see what sort of a place you've been living in.
No, please. It's pretty awful. I won't be long.
At last. I thought you'd never show up.
Waiting for me?
Sure. Think I was waiting for a train?
I'm sorry, but I can't imagine.
Don't you remember? I'm a friend of Madeline Hunt.
Oh. Oh, yes. Yes, of course. Excuse me.
She's in trouble.
Trouble?
You can't throw her down, not after what she's done for you. Why, all you got to do is tell him you're a stool pigeon.
Is that all?
Well, suppose it is tough on you. How about her? If she's convicted, what chance has she got? Her old man will cut her off cold, and with that kind of a record behind her, how's she going to get a job? Oh, can't you see what's going to happen? If she goes up, she may get to be just what they say she is now.
I guess you've drowned it out.
Drowned what out?
Doesn't matter. I'll do it.
Well, I told you wasn't one of those guys who'd mind just being bawled out by a judge.
What judge is it?
Just the right guy. We picked him. He'll never convict, not for a stool pigeon's mixed up in the case.
What's his name?
Morrison. See you next Tuesday.
I beg your pardon. Can you tell me where Mr. Lucano lives?
Yeah, in there.
Thank you.
That girl that just went in?
Yeah, yeah. Keen, ain't it?
Some gals have all the luck.
Oh, come on.
How do you know it's a frame-up? How can you be sure what happened after you left? Oh, Stephen, can't you see there's every reason for her to lie?
Oh, yes, yes, I suppose so, but I can't believe it.
But you say you scarcely know her. What if she is what they think? You suppose any other kind of a girl is going to stay all night in a man's room?
Oh, you don't understand. You're different, not like the girls in the village. They are, well, their standards are more like a man's.
I know women better than you do. Why, it's obvious. Even if she's innocent this time, I'll bet she hasn't been before and won't be again.
No, that isn't fair.
Oh, Stephen, why throw away our only chance of happiness? Throw me away for a gesture.
Oh, gesture.
Certainly, she'll never be convicted. Do you think any good-looking girl with a story like that is going to be sent to jail just on the word of a policeman?
They have been. They are, all the time.
Not by Tom. I know. I sat on the bench with him lots of times.
You mean you think that...
I tell you, I know. I know how he thinks, feels about things like that.
Oh, I wish I could believe it.
He'll let her go. I know it.
Then why not make sure? I tell him the whole thing.
You'll do nothing of the kind. As a judge, he'd feel it his duty to make it public. Oh, you've got to promise me you won't tell him.
Well, perhaps you know best.
You won't regret it, Stephen.
Of course, there is one thing.
What?
I'll have to tell her.
Well, now, Stephen, you can't do that.
I can't let her think I'm going to show up and then not be there.
But why, if she's going to get off anyway, why become involved with her again?
You'll have to leave that to me.
You act as though you were in love with that girl.
Now, don't be silly. Don't be silly. I hope you don't mind my coming here.
Oh, no, of course not, only I hate to have you see me looking like this.
It's absurd. You in a place like this.
Everything's a little absurd. You said that.
I have no right even to hope. To ask you to believe I wasn't in the frame-up.
I'd rather not think so.
You probably hate the sight of me.
I don't. You ought to be able to see that. Let's not talk about it.
Then please try to believe me. I can't. There is a reason why I mustn't come to court.
Oh?
But they are going to let you go. I am sure of it. I have reason at all to know.
Why? What makes you think so?
I can't explain. Not here. It involves other people. That's why I can't go to court. Not unless it's absolutely necessary.
Other people?
Yes, I am staying with them now, living in their apartment. And there are others. I have obligations, great obligations. I can't let their names be brought into this.
I see.
But if you need me, I come. Can you believe that?
Of course.
I really don't know why you should.
Don't you? I do.
Why?
I'd trust you any time.
I can't answer. Say anything. Not even let you know how I feel.
Sorry. Gotta stop now. Can't get you any longer.
Goodbye. And thank you for coming.
Goodbye.
Come along.
What?
Come along, dearie.
Women's court again today?
Yes, why? I thought I told you that yesterday.
Yes, yes, you did. But I thought perhaps you'd be there just Monday. That today you'd change.
No, they're all week. Ought to be in court now. I'm late.
Oh, by the way, Tom, could you spare a minute? There is something I must ask you.
All right, but make it fast, please.
Alice and I had a discussion. Suppose a girl, apparently a decent girl, says she was framed by the cop. If she had nobody to substantiate her story, if it was just her word against the cop, would anybody convict her?
What he means is, would you convict her?
Just on an officer's testimony.
How do I know? I'd have to hear the testimony. I'm sorry, old man, but I make it a practice never to give decisions out of court. Oh,
of course, I meant this only hypothetically. What do you usually do in a case like that?
Well, you let her go, don't you, Tom?
Say, what are you trying to do? Make my decisions for me? We can't let our women obstruct the wheels of justice, eh, Stephen? Well, I've really got to go. I'll see you both later.
Oh, don't worry. That's just like him. He's sure to let her go, only he hates to admit it in advance.
It didn't sound like it. If there were only some way of knowing.
I can tell. If he didn't always let them go, he wouldn't have resented my saying so. He just hates being told things.
I have to go down there.
Where?
To court.
Why?
Just to make it sure.
Oh, now, Stephen, please. I tell you, I'm sure.
But I am not. Not anymore.
You make it awfully hard for me. How can I believe that you love me? Here you are, ready to throw everything overboard. Me. Us. Our whole life for that girl. Why, if it were anyone else, you'd just smile and go on.
No, it's not true. Just because I smile at what other people do to me. What I do to myself is different. You must see that.
I don't. I only see what may happen to us. You don't realize what a sensation this will be. Your name will be in headlines all over the country. Then what chance have you got? You'll be like a criminal. Worse. No decent people will have anything to do with you. Oh, Stephen, wake up. Try and see things as they really are. Well, if this happened, even I. Yes, Stephen. Me too.
Still, I've got to go.
And I'm going with you. Oh, but darling, don't tell them everything. You don't have to. Not about your being a stool pigeon.
I won't, if I can help it.
My luck to slap a guy in the face and have him turn out to be on the vice squad. The minute he came in, I knew it was a frame-up. One of the other detectives said later they didn't have anything on me.
What detective? What's his name?
I don't know, but one of them said it honestly, Judge.
As a matter of fact, Miss Hunt, did any man, even friends of yours, ever come to your studio at night?
Practically never. Except to take me to dinner when there were a lot of people there, a party or something.
Then you swear there was nobody there that night? No man, that is?
Yes, sir. One man was there. But he just left. He went out only 2 or 3 minutes before the police came in. He must have passed them on the stairs.
If that's true, why isn't that man here? He should be in a position to testify. Having just left you, he would know you were alone. At the time, Detective Sergeant Mather swears he found a man in the place. So if you're telling the truth, why didn't you call this man as a witness?
Well, yes, Your Honor, but we did, and he said he'd come.
If the court please, we still hope that he'll show up.
Didn't you subpoena him?
No, Your Honor. We didn't think it was necessary.
Necessary? Why, it's vital to prove this girl's story if she's telling the truth.
But he sent word he'd be here, Your Honor.
That's hard to believe.
Suppose you tell us something more about this man. Who is he? What does he do?
Don't answer that. This has gone far enough. I can't permit any testimony with regard to this man if you can't produce him. We have only this girl's word that he exists at all. There's no value in going into the matter further.
But, Your Honor, maybe he's just late.
I'm sorry, Mr. Miller. We can't delay indefinitely. Hold up all these other cases on a possibility. Haven't you any other witnesses?
No, Your Honor.
Then I must give my decision. This court has every desire to give any young woman charged with an offense of this kind the benefit of all reasonable doubt.
And it is not my practice to accept, uncorroborated and at its face value, the testimony of any police officer merely because he is a representative of the law.
Especially where a recital of the facts is questioned by the defendant. But in this instance, there is every reason to believe that the defendant is lying.
If her story were true, she could prove it by producing this man she speaks of. Since she fails to do so, I have no alternative except to find her guilty.
Stephen, don't.
All right, step down, please. Next case, Rose Painter. Is Rose Painter here?
Yes, sir.
Hey, here he is. This is the guy, Your Honor.
Quiet, quiet.
Stephen. Just a minute, Your Honor. Here's our witness now. May I ask your decision be withdrawn? Can I put him on the stand?
Certainly, Mr. Miller. This is very surprising. The clerk will not record my decision.
Take the stand, please.
You solemnly swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God.
I do.
Sit down. What's your name?
Stephen Lucano.
And where do you live?
89 Harrow Street, until a few days ago.
What's your business? What do you do for a living?
At the moment, I am... Well, I am a business manager. I believe that's what you call it.
Look here, Major. This is all beyond me. What have you to do with this affair?
But, Your Honor, I know this girl. She didn't do anything. I left her place just a minute before she was arrested. There wasn't any time for her to do anything, for any man to come before the police broke in.
I don't get this at all. A few days ago, that other girl said she knew you. And now this. Furthermore, how could you tell when the police arrived if you'd already left?
I met them when they came upstairs.
They weren't in uniform, were they? How could you know they were the police?
I assume they were.
An assumption isn't evidence.
Just a minute, please, Your Honor. As a matter of fact, you knew the police personally, didn't you? The truth is, you've been operating as a stool pigeon under the name of Tony Pizzetti.
That's the second time you've been called a stool pigeon in this courtroom.
Well, Mr. Lucano, how about it? Going to answer the question? Or are you going to let this little girl go to jail?
I'll answer the question. I have worked with the police. That's true.
What do you mean, worked with the police? As a stool pigeon?
Yes, Your Honor. As a stool pigeon.
If the court please, expecting this man to be here, I subpoenaed some of the vice squad. He knows all of them. Send those detectives in. All of them.
O'Brien, 14th precinct. I worked for him on two cases. You'll find the girls' names in the records. Helen Astor and Mary, I think the last name is Earl.
Is that your name, O'Brien?
Yes, sir.
What precinct?
14th.
Schnitzer, 5th precinct.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Allen, 12th precinct.
Correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Burns, 19th precinct.
That's enough. Apparently you know these men. Do you mean to say they've all been responsible for such frame-ups as this case?
No, Your Honor. This is the only case where I told the detective there wasn't any evidence. And he made the arrest anyway.
Whom did you tell that there wasn't any evidence against this girl?
The man who led the raid. Detective Sergeant Mather.
Can you pick him out?
Yes, sir. He's sitting right over there.
Officer, put Sergeant Mather under arrest. Case against Madeline Hunt is dismissed.
The clerk's record in regard to Sergeant Mather will be sent to the police commissioner for trial.
The clerk will also send the record to the district attorney's office for criminal action against Sergeant Mather for perjury.
Oh, boy, what a story!
Have been in any condition for a courtroom.
Major Lucarno!
I've got to thank him. Where is he?
Major Lucarno!
Lucarno! Major Lucarno!
Shall I send after him, Judge?
No. He slipped away again.
There he is. You can't catch him. Got any money? Come on. You might at least have picked a 15 and 5 cent one. Hey, wait a minute, can't you? Will you step into our office? Where are you going?
Oh, doesn't make much difference, does it?
It does. I want to thank you.
For almost failing you?
I was sure you'd come. Won't you get in?
No, please.
Oh, go on. Get in. Get in. Learn about women from her.
I really should go along.
Can I take you?
Oh, no. No, thank you. You see, it's nowhere in particular. And it's a hard place to go in a taxi.
But we could try. I'd love to go nowhere. I've always wondered where that was.
You wouldn't like it when you get there. And besides, I can't let you.
Don't you want me?
Want you.
And I'm going.
Hey, stop that. Go on, get out of here. Haven't you got any sense?
Where to, lady?
To the park.
What park?
Any park.